We think one fossil species made and used one type of tool. Homo erectus made Acheulian tools. That's what we learn in introductory classes. New research shows that that is not the case. Smallest Homo erectus cranium in Africa and diverse stone tools found at Gona, Ethiopia. This made the headlines in March. It's the topic of today's video. Stay tuned. Hi, I'm Sang-Hee, Department of Anthropology at University of California, Riverside. Welcome to my channel, talking about human evolution and human adaptation. Subscribe, like, and set your alarm for new video updates. Today, I'm talking about Homo erectus, new Homo erectus fossil found in Gona, Ethiopia. This is the research that was the subject of the headline news that I showed you just now. Co-occurrence of Acheulian and Oldowan artifacts with Homo erectus cranial fossils from Gona, Afar, Ethiopia. The title says it all. Homo erectus used to be associated with Acheulian stone tools, Acheulian hand axes. Acheulian hand axes are the quintessential big game hunting tool. Thanks to Acheulian hand axes, Homo erectus could expand beyond Africa and to occupy Europe and Asia. But here, the new research hints that Homo erectus not only used Acheulian, but Oldowan artifacts as well. Oldowan stone tools are the stone tool industry that came before Acheulian. Co-occurrence of Acheulian and Oldowan artifacts with Homo erectus cranial fossils from Gona, Afar, Ethiopia. The title says it all. Acheulian hand axes are what is traditionally associated with Homo erectus fossils. But this research shows that Homo erectus not only used Acheulian, but the one that is traditionally known to occur before Acheulian, the Oldowan artifacts. The site is located in Gona, Afar, Ethiopia. Budisima at 1.26 million years is robust and large, whereas Dana, which is older, 1.6 to 1.5 million years ago, is smaller and more gracile, suggesting that Homo erectus was probably a sexually dimorphic species, meaning that there's a difference between males and females of the same species. Like many paleoanthropological research, it involved numerous researchers from all over the world, mostly from the United States. Gona in Ethiopia is right by the Awash River. This is where a lot of the Australopithecus, a lot of fossil hominins are found. And Gona, as you could see, is near Hadar and Dikika, where the famous skeletons Ardi and Lucy were found. And I also covered Dikika recently in one of the videos. Here are the fossils. A is Dana 5. A much smaller cranium than B, Budisima 12. This is the brow ridges, and here are the brow ridges. Looking on sideways, this is looking from the top, and this is looking from behind, the backside of the skull. This is the front side of the skull. And B, Budisima, this part is this part right here. So it's a piece of the brow ridges. You can see it's quite big. And this part is the same as this part in terms of anatomy. This is the frontal, looking at the brow ridge from the front. So this part corresponds to this part here. At 600 cc, it is a very small cranial capacity for Homo erectus, possibly the smallest cranial capacity for Homo erectus. This is the top view. Here is the brow ridges, the very quintessential Homo erectus shape. But the point of this research is this slide here, where you see in both Putisima and Dana are associated with two modes of stone tools. The Acheulian is called mode 2 and Oldowan is called mode 1. Here is the mode 1, Oldowan pebble tools, and here is the mode 2 Acheulian stone tools. Very simple point. Acheulian was made and used by Homo erectus as we have been thinking, but this new research shows that Homo erectus also made and used Oldowan. Come to think of it, it is not so surprising. When there's new technology, the new technology is an addition to the old technology. It is not as if one replaces the other. It doesn't happen that often. But sometimes we tend to presume that a particular stone tool is only associated with a particular fossil species. This new research shows that is not the case. Our hominin ancestors used whatever technology there was to adapt to and survive through various environments. That there is no one-to-one relationship between a fossil species and an archaeological industry, it seems like common sense, but often we presume there is. This research reminds us that that is not the case. Fossil species, our hominin ancestors, used various technology, diverse technology, to adapt to diverse environments. And perhaps that is the secret to their success in spreading all throughout the old world of Europe, Asia, expanding beyond Africa. Thank you for watching this video today. Please subscribe to my channel talking about human evolution and human adaptation. Like the videos and set your alarm for new video updates. Until next time, take care, stay safe, bye-bye.